careful, you guys.
You gals, too. And thanks for everything.
I can't stand goodbye. I always cry like a baby.
I promise. We'll go see your show as soon as we have time.
You better stick to that promise if you don't want to piss off a Marine cutie.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
See you soon.
Goodbye, girls. I'll never forget you.
We won't forget you either. Bye.
Well, we're on our own.
You got a problem with that? Being alone with me doesn't make you uncomfortable, does it?
Of course not, silly.
Hey, don't get mad. I was just kidding.
Come on, let's not waste any time. Hurry up, let's find someone who knows about the Hopi Indians.
Maybe we'll get lucky and run across an actual Hopi.
I doubt it, but you never know. I saw a path behind here. Let's go. Wait, my bootlace came untied. I'll catch up with you.
I'm gonna take a look from up there.
Hey! Ah! Gina! 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 Answer me! Gina! No! No!
Feeling sorry is not the answer.
Hey! Who are you? I didn't hear you come up.
I am Wupuchim, last of the Hopi chiefs. The answer is to continue on your mission, not to feel sorry.
How do you know all this? I don't understand how you... Hey, wait a minute. Did you say Hopi?
I did, of course.
That's incredible! I'm here to find out the meaning of a crucifix of Hopi origin.
Show me the object.
This is it.
My young friend, this is not a crucifix. It is a sacred key.
A key? But it's not shaped like a key.
The way you are holding it in your hand. Press strongly on the upper part with your thumb.
Oh. Well, it sure looks like a key now. And what is it this sacred key opens?
It is the key to the sacred Hopi crypt.
The sacred crypt? Where is this crypt?
Right across from our village, on the highest peak, on the other side of the Great Canyon, where Istrarok places his first ray at dawn.
Oh, and could you tell me how to get to the Hopi village?
The sacred key went to you, so your destiny is to reach the sacred crypt. What path to follow? The path of knowledge, no doubt.
Well, I think there's something I should tell you. You see, the truth is that this key... It's not mine. Hey! He disappeared! Now, how did he leave without me noticing? Just like when he came. Feeling sorry is not the answer. Huh. That's easy to say, but I feel I can't move one step now that Gina's... Well, he's right. The only thing I can do for Gina now is continue on the mission that brought us here. I owe it to her. Now I know the crucifix is actually the key to a crypt. If I manage to find the Hopi village, I'll be able to enter that sacred crypt. And I'll probably find an explanation for this whole mystery there. So, let's hop to it. Great. I have a good view of the whole area from here. Let's see. It looks like there's a small town over there. I'll go see if I can find someone who knows about the Hopi village. Wow. This place looks like something out of a John Ford movie. You've got your hotel, your sheriff's office, the typical saloon from the Old West. And there's even an old derailed steam-powered locomotive at the end of town. Wait, stop, don't shoot.
Who are you and what are you doing in my town? And put up your hand so I can see him.
Hey, hold your horses. I've come in peace. Look, my name is Brian. I'm a bit lost around here. Can you help me out?
Well, okay. I guess you're not lying. Come in and we can chat. So, you say you're lost, huh?
Well, maybe you can tell me how you got here, then.
Well, the truth is, I'm not totally lost. I'm trying to find a Hopi village that used to be inhabited somewhere in this region. I came into this town hoping to find information on its exact location.
The Hopi village. Are you an archaeologist or something like that?
No, I know nothing about archaeology. I need to find it for another reason.
You don't look like an archaeologist, to tell you the truth. Though, I suppose they don't all carry whips and wear hats.
Oh, give it a rest, please. Do you know where that Hopi village is or not?
This may sound strange, but the history of this town, Douglasville, is very closely related to the history of that Hopi village.
Really? In what way? Please explain.
Well, it's kind of a long story. Okay, well, here it goes. This village was founded by my great-grandfather, James Theodore Douglas. He was the owner of a gold mine nearby. And in the beginning, Douglasville was nothing more than a mining camp. But it grew bit by bit until turning into a flourishing town. Everyone was prosperous thanks to the huge profits of the mine. And my great-grandfather even got the railroad to run through Douglasville. However, something happened that tragically changed the town's fate. The mine and the mine shafts just kept growing and growing until one of them, the one with the largest vein of gold, bumped into something totally unexpected. The Hopi village!
Really? So what happened?
The inevitable. The Indians weren't willing to let white men ravage their lands. And J.T. Douglas wasn't the kind of man who would give up a fortune just because some Indians got in his way. So there was a bloodbath. It looked pretty bad for the Indians. They didn't have much to fight with, and a lot of them died. But then, something amazing changed everything. The Hopi tribe's medicine man came into Douglasville one morning at dawn, stood in the middle of town, and cast a terrible spell on it, the mine, and all the white men that might try to take over Hopi lands. They killed him on the spot, but not before the curse took effect.
What do you mean by that? What happened?
The mine inexplicably ran out of gold overnight, and not one more nugget of gold was ever taken out. The people in town started to catch a strange disease that the doctor couldn't cure. Whole families were driven out of Douglasville in fear, trying to get away from the curse. The final straw was when the train derailed. It went out of control through the town, destroying everything in its path. Its last obstacle was the Douglasville Bank, which it plowed into like a wild buffalo. As you might suspect, J.T. Douglas owned the bank, too. That's where he was sitting, in his fancy red French armchair brought in straight from Paris, when 50 tons of iron flattened him. Once my great-grandfather had died, the few people left in town were hot on their heels to get out of Douglasville, making it a ghost town.
That's a fascinating story. And you say you're the great-granddaughter of this J.T. Douglas?
Yes, I am. By the way, my name is Sushi. Sushi Douglas. And this town is really mine. The deed to it has been passed down from generation to generation until reaching me. And I was the first person to use it a year and a half ago. I came here to live with two friends, Kevin and Rutger, But up to then, it was completely abandoned.
The three of you live here alone? No way! Wow, Sushi. I can see you're really informed about the history of the region. So, I bet you can indicate the way to the remains of the Hopi village, right?
Well, actually I can't. The mine was sealed when all that stuff I told you about happened, and from the outside, I have absolutely no idea how to reach the Hopi village.
Ja, das war also diese, naja, etwas längere Zwischensequenz zwischen Kapitel 3 und Kapitel Nummer 4, in dem wir uns jetzt befinden. Und ja, viel ist passiert. Wir haben zwar die Flucht geschafft vor den beiden Mafiosi aus der Wüste, aber sind gleich ins nächste Desaster gestürzt, denn ja, Gina ist, naja, wir wissen es ja eigentlich nicht so wirklich, ob sie jetzt tot ist oder schwer verletzt da unten rumliegt. Oder ob es ihr gänzlich gut geht, wir wissen es einfach nicht. Da wir mit ihr auch anscheinend nicht geredet haben. Ja, die Trauerphase war allerdings auch nicht allzu lang, muss ich mal sagen. Also da mal kurz ein bisschen getrauert und dann nach dem Gespräch mit dem Hopi-Indianer hat auf einmal einen neuen Tatendrang entwickelt. Und ja, es ist also kein Kruzifix, sondern ein Schlüssel, der ja irgendwo im Hopi-Dorf verwendet werden kann zu einem großen, unbekannten Geheimnis. Das werden wir wohl noch herausfinden müssen, sonst würde das Spiel ja wenig Sinn machen. Und ja, jetzt haben wir also Douglasville als erstes erstmal erreicht, uns kurz mit Sushi unterhalten, die uns, naja, in der Kürze mal kurz die Geschichte von Douglasville erzählt hat. Und ja, mal gucken, was er uns noch so zu sagen hat, bevor wir jetzt weitergehen und dem Geheimnis des Schlüssels auf den Grund gehen.
It's about your great-grandfather's mine.
Sure, what is it?
So, was kann sie uns denn über die Mine noch erzählen? Do you know your way through the mineshafts? Ja, ob sie den Weg durch die Minengänge noch weiß?
Do you know your way through the mineshafts to reach the Hopi village?
Me? Not a chance. I've never gone into that old mine.
Hätte mich auch gewundert, weil, naja, die Mine ist ja Jahrzehnte vor ihr schon eigentlich unbrauchbar geworden. Ob es eine alte Karte gibt?
I thought you might have an old map of the mine.
No, I don't have any maps of it. Let me think. I guess that if a map exists, it would be in the town bank. Probably inside the safe.
Okay, also im Safe soll eine Karte von der Mine liegen, okay. Ja, ob sie wirklich daran denkt, dass so ein Hopi-Fluch daran schuld ist.
Do you really think the mine ran dry because of the Hopi medicine man's curse?
Well, I neither believe it nor deny it. What I do know is that the mine ran out of gold, even though such a thing seemed totally impossible days before. Not something very normal, don't you think?
Nee, eigentlich nicht. Von heute auf morgen auf einmal kein Gold mehr ausspucken. Nein, bitte nicht. Nochmal die ganze Geschichte. So, Kevin, Rutger and you. Warum leben Sie denn überhaupt hier?
Why did Kevin, Rutger and you come live out here?
It was my idea. I felt the need for total isolation so I could devote myself to my greatest passion. They had similar concerns. So here we are.
So, what's your passion?
Computers and the whole world of technology surrounding them. I'm pretty good at it, you know?
Ja, mitten in Nirvana irgendwie mit Computern umgehen? Ich wundere, dass sie überhaupt Strom haben. Wobei, wenn ich mich gerade umgucke, zumindest auf dem Bild ist nix mit Elektrizität zu sehen. Ah ja, okay. Gut.
I'm gonna continue on my search. Genau. Thanks for all your help, Sushi.
Thank
See you later.
See ya and good luck.
Okay, that's Sushi gewesen, Sushi Douglas. Und ja, das also das wunderschöne Douglasville, also Hotel, das Sheriff's Office, der Liquor Store, eine Bank. Da hinten ist noch der alte Train, also die Lokomotive. Und hier vorne geht's noch zum Saloon. Ja, wir gehen einfach mal jetzt hier den Weg ab. So, alter Wagen. Ich glaube, hier können wir uns nicht viel angucken. Generell so auf der Straße kann man sich nicht viel angucken. Außer den alten Karren hier, anscheinend.
This must have been a supply wagon, because it has some sort of strap attached to an iron ring at the edge. And there are more similar rings at each end of the wagon on both sides. I bet the strap passed through all of those rings over the goods to keep them from moving around on those dusty, bumpy old roads.
Also irgendwelche Seile können wir uns die nehmen.
It's tied to one of the iron rings. I can't tear it off.
Nee, leider nein. Na gut. So. Let's see. Ich mach einfach mal Doppelklick.
Way at the end, I see a cell and I can't believe my eyes. There's
Was? Was ist da?
A dead body. Oh man. That guy must have been rotting away for 100 years.
Dass ihn noch keiner rausgeholt hat. Aus der Zelle hier. Naja.
I wonder whether that poor devil died inside there. Or if he'd already kicked the bucket before they stuck him in there.
Oh, der wird wahrscheinlich gelebt haben, bevor er darin gebracht wurde. Können wir eigentlich die Tür öffnen? Nee, ne?
It's locked shut.
Okay, gibt's hier sonst noch irgendwas in der Zelle? Nee. Was war das? Locker Zell, nee. So, was haben wir hier?
Must
Firewood.
Be for that stove over there.
Können wir es mitnehmen?
Alright. I don't think anyone will need them to light up the stove. 5 nice logs. Might come in handy.
Ja, gut. Warum er einfach sinnloserweise 5 Holzstämme mitnimmt? Naja, der Brian wird schon wissen, warum. Beziehungsweise die Spieleentwickler. So, Wanted.
There's still some old Wanted signs up, offering a reward for capturing the bad guys.
Können wir welche mitnehmen?
Well, I'm no bounty hunter. And even if I were, I'm afraid all of these guys have been 6 feet under for at least a century.
Ja gut, das stimmt auch, ja. Von denen wird wahrscheinlich keiner mehr gesucht, weil einfach keiner mehr lebt. So, hier haben wir noch ein altes Desk.
An old frayed hat, a couple of pages from an old newspaper, and an oil lamp. Nothing of this will help me out.
Nee, selbst der Hut nicht?
I'm not interested in that.
Okay. Gun Kabinett.
There aren't any weapons left, just the chain that held them up.
Die Ketten können wir auch nicht mitnehmen, oder?
I can't. It's fixed to the cabinet. I don't think I'll need it anyway.
Gut, okay. Also auch sinnlos. Nix mehr für uns hier in dem Gefängnis. Gut, gehen wir raus. Gehen in den Liquor Store, falls wir da überhaupt reinkommen. Okay. Er läuft und läuft und läuft. Es sieht sehr vernagelt aus, das Ganze.
Impossible. I'd have to remove the boards on the door.
Achso, okay, wir müssen erst die Dinger wegmachen. Ah, okay. Haben wir nichts dabei, irgendwie so Brecheisen oder sowas. Aber in die Bank kommen wir.
Whoa! The bank sure is a mess.
Hier sollte ja auch der rote Schreibtisch, rote Stuhl sein.
I see the locomotive really wrecked the place when it derailed and smashed into the bank.
Hier war wahrscheinlich der rote Sessel aus Paris. Paris. Der J.T. Douglas dann quasi mitgenommen hat. Ins Grab. So geht's einfach mal gar nichts. Look at desk.
I bet this was J.T. Douglas's desk.
Douglas's desk.
B.D. Bank of Douglasville, I suppose.
B.D. Brian? Nee, Brian Vesco. Go to couch.
It's pretty old, but I bet it could be fixed.
Ja? Können wir das?
Don't tempt fate. The legs are worn out and might not hold up the weight.
Ja. Okay, können wir also auch nicht machen. Hier ist noch irgendwie so ein Riesenloch. Was haben wir da?
A big piece of the floor is missing. A blunt object must have fallen down and made that hole.
Können wir da reinklettern? Go down to the basement.
I don't see why I would want to go in there.
Ich gehe doch mal fest davon aus, dass da der Safe drin sein wird, von dem uns Sushi erzählt hat. Warum können wir da nicht reingehen? Kacke. Ah, Shelves. Gucken, ob wir da noch was finden. Da dieser Gegenstand sieht auch noch ein bisschen komisch aus.
This is really run down. All I see are old papers covered in dust. Then there's that metallic object down there.
Metallic object? Gucken wir mal, was ist das?
Not a clue what this is, but it seems to be in pretty good shape despite years of sitting on that shelf. Okay, I'll take it.
So, was ist das?
Whoa, this looks like a stapler.
Rudimentary
it is. Definitely a model from the 19th century. I'd better take the staples that were lying next to the stapler. They look similar to the rivets used by cobblers.
Ein Tacker, sehr schön. John Tacker. Cash Register, können wir mal klauen?
It's really old. Probably stopped working a long time ago. It'd make for a lovely decorative antique if someone cleaned it up.
Nehmen Sie mit.
It's open now. The drawer is slid out, but there's not a single penny.
Ah, Brian, Brian, Brian Basco, wirklich. Nix kann man mit dir anstellen. So, okay. Verlass mal die Bank wieder.